When you've been teaching anatomy as long as I have, there are three questions you tend to get asked more than any others. The first is, how bad do cadaver labs smell? Well, some are worse than others, but none of them smell like roses, that's for sure. Second, how do you remember all of those terms, considering there are around 10,000 anatomical terms that you'll need to know by the time of your finals? Practice. Lots of practice. But here's the thing. It gets easier as you go, and in my experience, most students become walking encyclopedias after just a few short months. And the third question is, what is the best anatomy textbook or anatomy atlas to best help me learn those terms and support my studies? Well, lucky for you, that's exactly what we're talking about today. We'll be discussing five of the best anatomy atlases available on the market. Now here's the thing. You really can't go wrong with any of these atlases. There's a reason they're on this list. So if you find yourself holding one of these atlases in the lab, don't worry, you're doing great. However, they are not the same. And our goal today is to discuss the pros and cons for each atlas, helping you decide which is the best for you. First up, we have the atlas that you can almost guarantee to find in every anatomy classroom in the entire world. And that's for good reason. The Netter Atlas of Human Anatomy. Netter's is colorful and vibrant with hand-drawn illustrations that are some of the best you're going to see. The drawings are highly detailed, clearly labeled, and organized into regions of the body. Let's now talk some of the pros of the Netter's Atlas. And as I just mentioned, the clear and colorful illustrations make the atlas a joy to look at. It's easy to see different structures as well as the nuances of the ones you're looking at. At the end of each section, you're gonna find a summary table providing a quick reference of all the main muscle key facts. Considering how tedious and similar skeletal muscles can be, this is a great addition. If you buy the physical version of the book, you'll get access to more plates, dissection videos, and quizzes online. Considering it's 2024, online resources like this are practically essential. Now let's take a look at some of the cons of the Netter's Atlas. As you thumb through the pages, you might feel like there's a label for every atom and molecule of the body. It can be overwhelming, which can become a pain as you're studying late into the night trying to find the needle in the haystack. Eye fatigue can be a real thing. Netter's also doesn't have much context and information to supplement the labels. Anatomy at its core is a science of labels, but sometimes a little more info can go a long way. But if you're just looking for the structure and not much else, it's not gonna be a big deal at all. It's thick. Hauling it around campus will basically be a workout, which if you can't make it to the gym that day, maybe that's a pro. Just know, it's a big book. A new paperback edition costs between $89 and $110, with the ebook version clocking in at $170, making Netter's pricier than other atlases. If you're a broke college student, that's probably a deal breaker, but if you can afford it, just know you're getting a fantastic book. Next up, we have Grant's Atlas of Anatomy. This is another staple in the anatomy world, having been around since 1943. If for some reason an anatomy or biology classroom doesn't have Netter's Atlas, they're bound to have Grant's Atlas instead. And if not, you're probably in a chemistry classroom, and this video is not going to be the most helpful to you. Let's now take a look at some of the pros of Grant's Atlas. The illustrations have an almost playful style to them. Personally, I love the style, and it gives an extremely approachable feel to the material. There are also additional descriptions and legends to the images too, not just labels. And some of these have clinical relevance, which can be really useful for those taking clinical anatomy or just looking for practical examples. Aside from the clinical context, Grant's also has some radiological images, including ultrasounds, x-rays, and MRIs. Being able to compare the illustrations with the clinical side of things can be hugely beneficial for making connections in the mind. I'm a huge fan of comparing typical anatomical views with medical images, so this is a huge plus for me. There's also summary tables throughout the atlas. This is particularly helpful for muscle anatomy since it gives the key information on muscle attachments, innervation, and functions. If you've studied skeletal muscles before, you know how beneficial this is. And now for some cons. Get ready to squint. The labeling text is really small. This is especially true in the ebook version, where people have reported about the constant need to zoom in to discern the letters. It's not the end of the world by any means, but it might factor into your satisfaction. This next one's kind of weird, or at least it is for me. See, the main chapters are organized into a logical regional approach, but for some reason, the sections inside of those chapters lack an intuitive organization. So for example, one part of a region is explained in a section, while the other part is covered much later in another section. So the information is all there. It's just not always where you'd expect. Grants does offer some online resources, but it's not a lot, with just a handful of videos on specific topics. Now, depending on your study habits, that might not be a big deal at all, but it does make studying a bit less convenient at times. This is another hefty book. At 887 pages, Grant's Atlas is pretty bulky, which means you're in for another workout around campus. Next up, we have Gilroy's Atlas of Anatomy. This is a relative newcomer in the world of anatomical atlases, first being published in 2012. Don't let the fact that it's Gen Alpha deter you. This is a great atlas, and in fact, it holds the number one spot on Amazon's list of best-selling medical atlases. This is one I've used many times over the years and absolutely love it. Let's talk some pros. Gilroy's has clinical boxes, which give the anatomy more context for clinical practice. If you're taking a clinical anatomy course, this alone is a huge plus. Usually atlases separate the anatomical knowledge from the clinical application, but Gilroy's instead provides a more holistic approach. You're simultaneously learning the anatomy and the clinical side of things, which is really cool and also a very practical way to learn. In its latest fourth edition, there are some new sections with radiology images, which can be really useful in trying to understand the anatomy from multiple viewpoints. There are also tables for reviewing muscle origins, insertions, innervations, and actions. Again, this is a huge plus for those of you needing to learn skeletal muscle anatomy. While not the cheapest on this list, it's certainly not the most expensive either. You can find this on Amazon for around $44 to $66. So it shouldn't break the bank by any means. All right, now for some cons. You'll often hear people criticizing its illustrations, which you could argue are too basic and digital. It's never really bothered me much, but that's definitely a personal preference. Some might feel that the balance between the clinical correlations and the anatomy nuances is off. It's possible that by not fully focusing on either the clinical or the anatomy side of things gives it a bit of an identity crisis. This is another bulky book. Will it look good on your bookshelf? Absolutely. Will it give your legs and shoulders a workout? Most definitely. Then we have one of my personal favorites, Rohen's Color Atlas of Anatomy. The difference between this atlas and each of the others on this list is the fact that it utilizes real-life photographs to teach human anatomy. As someone who has spent the better part of the last decade teaching with real human cadavers, there is a level of knowledge that is gained that simply can't be gained from illustrations. With that said, let's see if it's right for you. Let's talk some pros. The easy standout of Rohen's Atlas is its real-life photographs of cadaver dissections, bones, and radiographs. From both a clinical and nerdy point of view, this is just awesome and difficult to beat. The atlas is extremely clear and organized with its labels utilizing diverse colors to help differentiate anatomical structures. It also has a crisp and clear layout, which makes it easier for students to navigate and absorb the information. There are clinical comments throughout the atlas that improve understanding and clinical application, which helps students prepare for exams and even real-world medical settings as well. And now for the cons. If you prefer drawings and illustrations to real photographs, this probably shouldn't be your first choice. While there's real value in a book like this, if you find it gloomy and depressing, that's not going to be helpful either. Considering it uses real photographs, some subtle anatomical details might be harder to discern compared to more stylized illustrative atlases. If you're looking to understand and learn the finer anatomical details and nuances, this probably shouldn't be your first choice. It's also on the pricier side, with the paperback edition costing $98 and the ebook version costing $97. So given the fact that most college and university students are on a pretty tight budget, $100 isn't exactly cheap. And last, but certainly not least, we have the Kenhub Atlas of Human Anatomy. Now, before we dive into the Kenhub Atlas, I want to take a moment and acknowledge the fact that as a Kenhub video, it is difficult, if not just simply impossible, to provide a completely unbiased perspective. But I believe in transparency, and I want to provide as clear of a picture as I possibly can about this atlas, including its strengths, its limitations, so you can make an informed decision about whether or not this is the right choice for you. Please keep in mind that this section is not a review. It is a walkthrough of some of the key characteristics of the Kenhub Atlas. And I can tell you, this is a fantastic book. It was crafted for some very specific features, which were formulated by direct input from students and experienced educators. While this is the newest kid on the block when it comes to anatomy atlases, it benefits from Kenhub's great reputation through their online anatomy atlas. So, without further ado, let's talk some strengths of the Kenhub Atlas. This was specifically designed to fit the usual lab coat, making it far more practical for traveling around campus in the lab, not breaking your back along the way. It also provides context and detailed descriptions of the anatomical structures. This is great for the visual learners, as well as those looking to get into the nitty-gritty side of things. The labels are carefully curated, so each image has only what's relevant for the topic. Color-coded legends and other types of visual emphasis allow you to easily focus on the must-know information. There are precise tables and cheat sheets, meaning you don't have to flip pages and search for references throughout the book. The models within the anatomical illustrations feature various ethnicities and gender distribution, which represents a significant shift towards a more inclusive and equitable learning environment in anatomy education. There's also a ton of online learning resources on kenhub.com, which includes online atlas galleries, articles, study units, videos, and quizzes. Then, in one of the coolest features, there are several QR codes in each study section to instantly connect the atlas to the corresponding topic at kenhub.com. Seriously cool. And then, retailing at around $45, it's the most affordable atlas on the market. Now let's look at some of the limitations. One downside is the lack of clinical correlation at the end of each section, but Kenhub is looking to include this in one of the next editions. There aren't any cadaver images, which might be a drawback for someone studying specifically for dissection classes. While there isn't any medical imaging content in the current edition of the physical book, you can find them on the Kenhub website, which is perfectly integrated with the Atlas. Being pocket size does come with its drawbacks, and that is the fact that the text is quite small. Some people with visual impairments or older people might need to make an effort to be able to read the text. If the Kenhub Atlas has piqued your interest and you'd like to explore it further, I encourage you to visit the link in the description below. There you'll find more information on how to purchase the Atlas, as well as an opportunity to download some free pages. This way, you get a firsthand look at the content and style of the Atlas, helping you to determine if it's perfect for your anatomy learning needs. Again though, you really can't go wrong with any of these atlases, but just understand this is an investment and not just a financial one. Anatomy atlases are tools to master the human body, and just as with any other tool, some are a better fit for certain jobs. I want you to ask yourself these types of questions when you're looking for an atlas. Does my anatomy course have a lab component? Does my lab have any dissection? How good is my anatomy textbook? How important are online resources to me? How much money can I spend on an atlas? Do I need clinical and cadaveric content integrated into the atlas? A good anatomy atlas is something you're going to want to keep on your bookshelf for years to come in both a personal and professional sense. So hopefully this video has helped you get a little bit closer to making that decision. Be sure to like and subscribe if you haven't, and also be sure to leave a comment letting us know which anatomy atlas you prefer and why. Thanks for watching, everyone.